Hi, my name is David. I'm a lifelong Republican. I live in Oakland, California. I voted for George W. Bush, McCain, Romney as well. And I remember going over to my grandfather's house when I was probably 3 years old and seeing pictures of Ronald Reagan on the wall with a big smile on his face. I don't think my politics have changed very much in the last 4 years. I didn't vote for Donald Trump in 2016, though being a Republican, because I didn't think he was fit to lead the country. I remember seeing some of the debate performances, especially the second presidential debate with Hillary Clinton, where they got into foreign policy, and I thought it completely fell apart. Somewhat to my shock, things have turned out even worse than I thought they would. I think as we head into this election in 2020, it's really important to think about, you know, what does it mean to be a conservative today in 2020? And some of the things that are important to me, one is family. I want somebody who is proud of their family, not somebody who runs around having affairs and then paying hush money to porn stars to cover it up. Also, limited government's very important to me with regards to both business. I think all the tariffs and the trade war that's happening have been a disaster, especially for small farmers and other people. Also, you know, for religion, you should be able to practice whatever religion you want. I think respecting people is also very important. Not making fun of, you know, men, whether they're in the military, women, or even people with disabilities or minorities, all of which this president has done. I also think respecting the military is important, not going around its chain of command when you think it's convenient and pushing out all the generals that you're trying to get to help you. And finally, obviously, balancing the budget and fiscal discipline. I was really, really sad to see that we spent over $1 trillion in the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act. And for what? All it was a stimulus in the middle of a boom time. You know, now we're at what, 15% national unemployment, and we're going to be paying that $1 trillion that was added to the national debt for who knows how long, maybe decades. I'm tired of having to apologize for my country. I live and work in Silicon Valley with a lot of people who aren't from this country. One of them, Mengxin, lives down the hall from me in the building where I live, and she's from mainland China and went to Harvard, and I have to keep explaining to her that, you know, why is it that we can't get our act together in this country and get the coronavirus under control? I'm tired of telling two of my best friends in the Kill and Comedy that I'm not sure whether they're going to be able to live here, even though they've lived in this country for 15 years and have a child together. Comedy works on creating some of the precursors for a COVID test. So she's helping to get people tested. And Nikhil works creating software to help kids in schools learn better. These are the people who we're turning away. And finally, I'm tired of having other world leaders laugh at us at the G8 summit. You know, when the mic's off, they're all laughing at Donald Trump, you know, how he doesn't know anything, how he's a buffoon, and he doesn't represent us well. On a slightly lighter note, I was talking to my friend Drew recently, and I'm not sure if any of you remember Arugula-gate in 2014 or 2015. Everybody was up in arms because the president liked arugula. Those were our scandals. These days, our scandals are the fact that this president has had numerous convicted felons in his inner circle. The fact that he is paying hush money to porn stars in order to cover up his affairs. The fact that he tried to trade favors to swing the election in Ukraine. These things are unprecedented in the history of our country, and they're putting our republic in danger. I don't even like Joe Biden that much, but I'm pretty sure that we're not going to have scandal after scandal with him. I think he's going to be a better representative of the country, so I will be voting for him. Again, not without some disdain, but I can't imagine what this country will look like after 4 more years of our current president.